Today we are going to carry out automated model building using AutoBuild. Iterative model building is a way to simultaneously improve the quality of your electron density map and to build a model. In a diffraction experiment, the phase information is lost. We need both intensities and phases to calculate a map. If we have a starting map and can build and refine a model based on it, we can improve the phases using our model and density modification. This improves the map even in places we didn't build a model. Here is how AutoBuild is going to build a model for us. We start with phase information from a model or experimental phases. AutoBuild will carry out cycles of density modification, model building, and refinement to yield a new model and an improved map. If high-resolution data is available, the phase information will be extended to high resolution. If we start with experimental phase information, AutoBuild will carry out specialized density modification and model building based on finding local patterns of density. This step is called iterative building. Rebuilding starting with a model is called iterative rebuilding. In case we are starting with a model, we have two main choices of how to use this model. Standard rebuilding adds and deletes residues as necessary. It rebuilds everything. Alternatively, we can just move the residues in this model around. This is called rebuild in place because the model is rebuilt where it is with no changes in connectivity. You can think of it as extensive refinement. Let's carry out automatic model building starting from measured intensities and low-resolution experimental phases such as you might get from AutoSol, and a high-resolution file for phase extension and refinement. Let's use demo data from the Phoenix tutorials. In the main Phoenix GUI, click on New Project, then Setup Tutorial Data, and choose the first tutorial under Model Building. Select a suitable location to put this folder and click OK. In the main Phoenix GUI, under the Model Building tab, select AutoBuild. Let's put in a title. Let's select some data. Click Add File to see the copied tutorial folder. Seek.dat is our sequence file. P9DataAndPhases.mtz contains low-resolution measured data and experimental phases. P9HighRes.mtz has high-resolution data. Click Open to load the files. Now let's tell the GUI what these files contain. The GUI correctly guessed the seek.dat is a sequence file. Select this P9DataAndPhases.mtz data file. The GUI incorrectly guessed it is an initial map. Click on Modify File Data Type to fix this. Turn on Experimental Data to indicate that experimental phases are present in this file. Turn off Initial Map. Now the GUI knows this file contains experimental phase information. Tell the GUI that P9HighResMTZ contains high-res information. Click on the Other Options tab. We're going to set a few parameters. Make sure the space group and unit cell are what we expect. Set the number of processors. Now, just to run quickly, select Quick Mode. Set the maximum iterative build and iterative rebuild steps to 1. Set Build Outside Model to False. This turns off a step where density is removed wherever there is already model built. Let's leave Place Waters in Refinement as true. These waters are both true waters and placeholders for something is present here that assist in refinement and model building. We will also leave Rebuild in Place set to auto. If we had supplied a model, then we could set Rebuild in Place to true if we wanted to keep the connectivity, or false if we wanted to rebuild it completely. We're ready to go. Click on Run and then Run Now to start the run. Once you hit Run, a new AutoBuild Run tab appears and additional subtabs will appear as the run proceeds. The Summary tab shows the files produced and the overall statistics for the run. This model was built with 2.5 angstrom data. Notice the free R value, the number of residues built, and the number of fragments making up the model. At this resolution, a free R in the 20s or low 30s and most of the model built in fragments that are about 50 residues or more in length is just fine. In the AutoBuild GUI, the Models tab shows a summary of models built during the run. The Structure Status tab shows secondary structure in your model. The Summary tab is an Open in Qt button that will load the final model and map. This is a fine model and map for 3 angstrom data. The next step after running AutoBuild is to run Phoenix Refine and to use the Qt interface to Phoenix Refine to fix up problem areas in your model. Then you can carry out more cycles of auto-building and manual improvement until you have a complete model. You might then run ligand fitting to place any ligands in your model, followed by final refinement. If you have questions or feedback, you're welcome to contact us at help@phoenixonline.org or tutorials@phoenixonline.org.